How to use Zoom breakout rooms on Windows. Breakout rooms allow you to split your Zoom meeting into up to 50 separate sessions. The meeting host can split the participants of the meeting into this separate session, automatically or manual, and switch between sessions at any time. Please note this option is available for now only on PC or laptop. Usually, Zoom breakout rooms can be used on any account, free or paid. This option is not active by default, so you have to set it up to use it. Why should you use it? This option has so many uses that it would take me hours to mention it. Imagine you are a teacher and you wish to give an assignment to be worked on groups. This is perfect for this situation. But let's see how we can use this option. To enable the breakout rooms feature, go to zoom.us. Sign in into Zoom web portal. In the navigation from the left menu, click Settings. Navigate to the breakout room option. You can click on In Meeting Advanced to get there faster. If the setting is disabled, click the toggle to enable it. If a verification dialog display, choose Turn On to verify the change. Note, if this option is grayed out, it has been locked at either the group or account level, and you will need to contact your Zoom administrator. Click the checkbox to allow meeting host to pre-assign participant to breakout rooms. Now Zoom Rooms on Windows is enabled for your account. But how to use Zoom breakout rooms? Let's start a meeting with a few test users to see how this works. You see here I have a meeting with 4 people on it. Let me show you how breakout rooms works. First, click on Breakout Rooms option from the bottom right. On this pop-up window, you need to specify first how many rooms you wish to have. You can select and add as many as you like. Now, after that, we have 2 options, automatically and manually. If you select automatically, the rooms will be created automatically and the people will be randomly allocated to the rooms. This option is useful if you need something random. Please note if you choose automatically and if you tap on create rooms, you will not be able to add a new room after you start. You can also choose manually, which will give you the ability to assign user to a specific room. Let's select manually and click create rooms. Because we have selected manually, we get to this window. Please note that if you open the rooms, you will not be able to create a new room, so my advice for you is to create an extra room every time, just in case you need it. If you need to create a spare room after you started the room, you will need to recreate all rooms and go through the process again. In every room, you have rename, delete, and also assign user to the room. Let's rename the rooms first. Click on rename and change the name. Let's assign some person to the first room. Click on Assign and check the checkboxes for the person you wish to add. Now let's click a bit on Option. Here we have some very good options. We have the option to move all participants automatically. Also, option to allow participants to return to the main session at any time. You can set up a timer for the breakout rooms, if you have something like a 10-minute exercise. And the last option is the countdown after the session on break rooms ends. You can specify the number of seconds after the time is finished, so the room to close. Let's click on Open All Rooms. Now all participants need to accept the join for the room. You can send a message to all participants by clicking Broadcast a message to all. Because you are the host, you can join in any room. Click on Join to go to that room. Also, it is possible to receive a message like this. A user has asked for help. This is very useful. Tap on Join Breakroom. After you have finished what you wanted, just click on Leave. You can end the meeting for all, leave meeting, or just leave the break room and return to the main meeting. This is how you use breakout rooms on Zoom for Windows. If this was useful, please like, share, and subscribe. Also, if you have any questions, please ask them in the comments area below.